In this video, we'll be discussing about NF-kappa-B signaling pathway, also known as NFKB pathway. This is the pathway which is initiated by TNF-alpha molecules. We know TNF-alpha has capability to drive apoptosis, but also TNF-alpha can skip this apoptosis and drive cell survival pathways in the form of inflammation by cytokine production in NFKB pathway or NF-kappa-B pathway. In apoptosis, RIP and PAD molecules are the central regulatory molecules, which are regulated by TRAD. While as in NFKB pathway, RIP and TRAP2 are the central regulatory molecules, which are regulated by TRAD also. Furthermore, we see RIP and PAD starts the caspase cascade, with which there is an induction of cell death in apoptosis pathway. While as on the right, we see RIP and TRAP2 activates NFKB pathway, with which the cell survives. Now let's see in detail how this NFKB pathway is driven and how apoptosis is inhibited in that process. In this diagram, we can see a cell with outer membrane as a plasma membrane and the inner as a nuclear membrane. On the plasma membrane, it has got TNFR1 receptor, or you can say TNF receptor, having dead domain on its intracellular side. Prior to any extracellular signal or any ligand binding towards TNF receptor, we see TNFR has got a molecule attached on its intracellular side in the form of SODD protein, silencer of death domain. The SODD keeps the death domain of TNFR in its inactive state. But when the TNF alpha molecule, when the signaling molecule binds to the TNF receptor, it causes the conformational changes in TNFR receptor, with which first of all the SODD is released from dead domain. And after that, the TRAD protein comes in and binds with the dead domain of TNFR, which furthermore recruits another protein called the TRAP2. Now, it's from here the apoptosis will be skipped and we will move towards the NFKB pathway. Here we see TRAD and TRAP complex recruits IAP protein, which is an inhibitor of apoptosis. We see here the IAP protein comes in and binds TRAP2, with which the apoptosis is inhibited. So now the apoptosis is inhibited. Now the cell will lead towards the NFKB pathway. In the next step, we see TRAP also recruits RIP protein, and this RIP protein further activates the IKK molecule, which has kinase activity. Now let's keep it here. On the other side, we see we have an NFKB molecule, but it's rendered inactive by IKBA protein. The IKBA masks the NLS signal, that's nuclear localization signal of NFKB. So when the NLS signal is masked, it cannot be translocated to the nucleus. So what we have to do here is that we have to remove this IKBA molecule from NFKB molecule so that it becomes active. So to do this activity, we have already activated IKK molecule. This IKK phosphorylates the IKBA molecule. Thus, the phosphorylated IKBA will be degraded by proteasomes. Then from here, we see the NFKB molecule disassociates from IKBA molecule. So now the NFKB molecule is free to go into the nucleus. It gets into the nucleus where it targets the pro-inflammatory genes and several other genes, and drives the expression of these genes, like we get cytokine production and other pro-inflammatory proteins, and also we get the expression of some anti-apoptotic genes in NFKB pathway. So this is how the TNF-alpha initiates the NFKB pathway. I hope you like the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Do consider supporting my work on Patreon, and also make sure to subscribe this channel. Thanks.